Minister Kasaija was presiding over a handover of startup Artisan Tools at Karunguza in Chibale Town Council. Kasaija noted that some youth waste time gambling and engaging in lawful behavior which leads to imprisonment, unwanted pregnancies and poverty.
Giving these gifts to them, I advised them on two things. One, be careful, they are still young. Be careful with their lives. Particularly for the young girls to get pregnant when they are not yet got married. And of course the boys, also I warned them that putting a girl in a family way is very dangerous and can even take them to court and eventually to jail. But also looking after the baby when you don't have enough resources can also be a...
The minister further appealed to the youth to put into use the skills acquired and to utilize the tools given to them, as well as embrace the parish development model.
To empower the youth in the three sub-counties in this constituency which I represent. They have been skilled in welding, in the carpentry, in the hairdressing, and in addition, that we have been donated the equipment, particularly wheelchairs.
Reverend Father Majesi Francis Xavier, the Executive Director, Hoima Caritas Development Organization, says a total of 226 youth and 36 people with disabilities have been trained and given tools.
A number of them were suggested to include tailoring, include saloons, include welding. We had the component on mechanical engineering, and we sent out adverts calling students, pupils to apply, and we received so many applications, but we were able to support only 226 applicants.
The beneficiaries were overjoyed and thanked leaders for sponsoring their training. We dropped out of school while in primary school and had no jobs. But after being trained in carpentry, welding, saloon and tailoring, we can now earn some money. We shall also use the equipment given to us to earn a living.
We have youth livelihood program whereby in Kivale alone we have around 521 beneficiaries. We have a yoga. We have beneficiaries who are around 200, PDM the same. So all these programs are here to empower, to boost the enterprises of the youth who are doing something. But I encourage the young people not to engage in unproductive activity, to concentrate much in productive activity.
The main purpose of this training was to create employable skills and competences relevant in the labor market instead of educational certificates. It embraces all Ugandans in need of skills, including school leavers. Story compiled by Andrew Msenguzi for the news.